story I want to tell you takes place in the San Blas Islands of Panama. Cuna Indians have lived here for hundreds of years. But it has only been a few years since missionaries began schools on these islands. Now the schools are run by local Christian people. Each year, the people celebrate Panama's independence. Colorful parades are followed by the biggest event for the school children, the annual sports competition. Manuel, who had come to live with his uncle while attending school, was one of the boys who would participate in the sports events. He was not only a good athlete, but also a fine Christian. Manuel was a hard worker. This pleased Iberio, the school champion for the last 2 years. He didn't mind seeing Manuel working so hard. This would give Manuel little time to practice. I want to be the champion again this year, Iberio kept telling himself. With the money Manuel would earn from his crop, he might save enough to go to Panama City to high school or perhaps even to college. Iberio's parents knew of the pride and jealousy in their son's heart. Only Jesus could change him. And even though Iberio knew this, he wanted no part of it. It was different with Manuel. He loved the Bible. He had trusted in Jesus Christ as his Savior.
Before we begin the first race, let me remind you, Iberio has been our champion for the last 2 years. But even though others of you have not won, and even though there can only be one champion this year, let us remember that most important of all is to be good sports.
Iberio proudly fastened the headscarf he always wore in sports competition. He was thinking so intently of winning, he paid little attention to the teacher's words as he reminded the boys of the school motto. All things for Christ, the teacher said. This should be your aim, whether you win or lose. Iberio won the 100-yard dash just as everybody expected. But it was Huane who won the swimming competition, with Manuel placing second and Iberio barely placing third. In fact, Manuel was among the three qualifiers for the important Cayuca race. This concerned Iberio. He knew he had to win this race to stay ahead. Right now, he was barely leading with 3 points. Arms ached. He was paddling so hard. But though he did his best, Manuel moved slowly into the lead and won. Now Manuel had 11 points and Iberio only 9. Sleep was far from Iberio's mind. He had to win the long race. He had to. And somehow Manuel must not win any more points. What could he do? Was there perhaps some way to keep Manuel from entering the race? Suddenly he got an idea. Iberio's heart beat like the pounding of the waves when there's a storm on the sea. He would burn down Manuel's crops of grain. That would keep Manuel from running in the long race. That would make him forget all about the sports competition.
You have heard the bad news. A fire destroyed all of Manuel's grain last night. Because there has been no rain, it spread and destroyed his uncle's cribs, too. It is a bad loss. There was no storm. There could have been no lightning. We do not know what caused the fire. We will not hold the long race tomorrow as planned. We will wait for Manuel's sake. Those of you who are in classes with me this morning, we'll spend the time in study hall. I am going to get Manuel and go to the mainland. Maybe I can help solve this mystery.
Fear began to come to Iberio's heart. What if he was found out?
Come in.
I wanted to talk to you earlier today, but I couldn't. I thought perhaps I should wait until your husband returned from Panama City.
My husband comes back tomorrow. What is wrong?
This is what troubles me.
Oh, no. This is Iberio's handkerchief. Does this mean our son set the fire? How terrible.
Could we talk to Iberio?
Yes.
Iberio is gone. He is not in his room. Iberio.
Why had he done it? The wages of sin is death. Would God punish him for what he did? Iberio had to get away from it all. He just had to. He remembered his teacher's words. All things for Christ. Who was Jesus Christ anyway? Iberio knew that, in a way, he had run away from God all of his life. Surely God didn't care what would happen to him now. Or did he? Hidden Island. There were superstitions of this place, stories about pirates and ghosts. Many fishermen would not come near the island. At least Iberio knew it was one place no one would think to look.
Thank you.
At first, Iberio thought he had been dreaming. But then it came back to him. The sports competition. The fire. His escape to Hidden Island. But he couldn't stay here. The Cayuga. Wasn't it here? Or had he come in from another part of the island? The Cayuga. He had to have his Cayuga. Fear gripped his heart. Why had he come here? What a fool he was. He was a prisoner. A prisoner on Hidden Island. Back at home, Iberio's parents had searched everywhere but had found no trace of their son. And then...
there is news. A fisherman has just brought Iberio's Cayuga. He thinks it was floating in the direction from Hidden Island.
Thirsty. So thirsty. If only he had a drink. Just one little drink of cool, fresh water. He would die. He knew he would. Why hadn't he listened to his parents? Why had he closed his heart to God's voice? The water felt refreshing, but what he didn't remember was the sharks around Hidden Island. Of sin is death. That's what he heard his parents read to him from the Bible. But was this the end? Was this God's punishment? The wages of sin is death. Iberio might never again be able to take part in sports as he had once done, but he would not be seriously crippled. It had been a hard lesson, but now he was willing to listen to God's voice. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Please, God, Iberio prayed, forgive me. I believe Jesus died on the cross for my sins. I accept him right now as my Savior. God gave Iberio a new heart. God gave him a new friend, too, Manuel. He would never forget the experience of Hidden Island. It had been a fearful experience, but Iberio wouldn't think of that. No, he would remember Hidden Island as the place where he learned how good and wise it is to be a Christian.